plants need five things to grow. They need water, they need air, they need light, they need nutrients, and they need a proper temperature. Right now it's 22 degrees, the snow is blowing, the sky is overcast, and none of my plants outside are receiving those five things. But by moving into the house, I can provide my plants with everything they need. Hi, I'm Gardener Scott. This is the time of year when I begin thinking about the seedlings that I'll be growing to put in my garden in just a few months. So join me as I begin that process and show you how I grow seedlings. Of the five factors for plant growth, water, air, light, nutrients, and proper temperature, there are some factors that are more important than others when it comes to growing seedlings. The air, well, that's all around us, so that really isn't something to worry about. So let's put that at the bottom of the list right now. The nutrients, I'll be discussing in the next video. The water, it's important, but we'll also cover that in the next video. The top two factors for determining where you start your seedlings are light and the proper temperature. So I'm sitting by the window in my dining room to discuss those top two factors. Many gardeners start seedlings next to a window, and that can be good, but it's all based on where you live. Remember, it's 22 degrees outside for me right now, and next to the window, I can feel that the air is cooler than the air in the room, and seedlings require warmth as their proper temperature. So starting seedlings next to a window may not be the best location when you think about temperature. When you think about light, you might also look and think, oh, there's plenty of light coming in. But seedlings require more light than established plants. If your window faces south, this time of year, in the deep, dark days of winter, you might get 6 hours of sunlight, assuming it's not overcast, assuming that the light is unrestricted coming through the window. But that 6 hours is probably not enough. This window faces east. I get the morning light and little after. So it's definitely not a good location for me. For an established plant like this bonsai, it's enough, but it's not enough for seedlings. Here's an important number. Seedlings require 15 hours of light each day. And I can't think of very many windows in the winter that will provide that much light. The seedlings can get by with 12 hours of light, but 15 is really what you should target. And that's why I recommend moving your growing operation into a room where you can provide that much light for your growing plants. It doesn't need to be fancy. All you need is light. This is an old broken floor lamp, but it's light that I can give to my plants. So if I've started seedlings, this light is all that I need. When seedlings don't get enough light, they grow searching for it. So you may have had the experience where the seedlings grow long, leggy is what we call it. If they're growing by a window, they might actually start growing towards the window in that effort to get more light. So you have a tall, leggy, bent seedling when you try to grow it in a location that doesn't get enough light. To avoid that leggy growth when you have your grow operations in an interior spot, the light really needs to be close to the plants. So that's one reason why I use this floor lamp for some of my lights, because I can put the lamp directly over the seedlings. And as the seedlings grow, I can raise the lamp. We want the light to be about 2 inches, maybe 3 inches above the plants as they grow. So as you set up the location where you're growing your seedlings, anticipate that. Think about putting a light source that is movable. That will give you the strongest plants. Don't be tempted to think that more light is better. Just like people, plants need a period of rest. They do need some darkness. Some very important things happen within the plant growth cycle during darkness. So 15 hours should be your target. Depending on your schedule, that may mean turning on the light when you get up in the morning and turning off the light when you go to bed at night. If you're putting your lights in a location that might add a little bit of extra work to turn them on and turn them off, get a timer. That's what I do. I plug all of my lights into timers, and then I set the timer for 15 hours of light. If you'll just be growing a few plants, a basic system like that floor lamp or a desk lamp is all you need. But if you're going to be growing more plants, like a full flat or maybe more, maybe consider something like this. This is just my storeroom, but I took a shelf and I installed a 24-inch fluorescent lamp above the shelf. This is perfectly sized for a flat of seedlings. And I have it on chains so I can raise and lower the lights. I don't come into this room often, but when I set it on a timer, it virtually takes care of itself. And I just raise the lamp as the plants grow. If you have the space, and if you're planning on growing a lot of seedlings, consider trying to find a spot in your house where you can set up a dedicated grow operation. This is the back corner of my furnace room, and I just added a little short wall, and then I hung this fluorescent light. It has 6 tubes in it. It's 48 inches long, and it can supply a lot of light to a lot of flats underneath it. And to add to the amount of light that the plants receive, I'm tacking up these Mylar safety blankets onto the drywall. They'll help reflect the light and really make it a good location for the seedlings to grow. These Mylar sheets will add a lot of reflective light to this space, and they're very inexpensive. They just come folded up, ready to go. There's a link below that shows you where I got my Mylar blankets. This space is just about ready to start growing seedlings. And when the light is turned on, there's a lot of reflection. And for 15 hours a day, my seedlings are going to be very happy. As the final step, I've added a 2-foot by 4-foot table underneath this light. And with all this reflective mylar, I can easily grow 4 full flats underneath these lights. Each of these flats has 72 cells. So we're talking almost 300 seedlings that I can start in this little grower corner. Now, most of those seedlings will be transplanted into bigger pots at some point during their growth. That's where this design really comes in handy, because I can raise and lower this light on these chains. All I need to do is remove this table and then place all those individual pots on the floor. Lower the light to just a few inches above the plants, and this whole space will be growing seedlings. You're probably thinking that that corner isn't big enough for 300 pots. I'm not planning on growing that many seedlings, but that corner probably won't be big enough for the ones that I will be growing. So I added another light just a few feet away from that growing corner. This is where I'll put the overflow of the pots. This light too is on a chain to raise it and lower it as necessary. So just a few feet away from my water heater is a space I rarely go. So why not put some pots there and grow some seedlings? 10 years ago, I didn't have the luxury of space. The house we lived in was much smaller, but I did have a back bedroom with an available corner. And I put one of those 2-foot by 4-foot tables and built this structure. It's perfectly sized to support just a single set of fluorescent lights. And underneath it, I could grow all of these little individual pots, enough for me to put in my garden in the spring. I've mentioned fluorescent lights a number of times so far, and you might be wondering, well, don't I need some special type of grow light for my seedlings? Well, no, you really don't. Light is all you need. Yes, if you're a commercial grower or you're trying to grow a special product, you might be more concerned about the wavelengths of various types of bulbs. But for just growing seedlings at home, a fluorescent bulb is all you need. If you have a light like this type, LED bulbs are perfectly fine. If you still have incandescent bulbs, those are perfectly fine too. And that leads us into one of those other important factors, the temperature. We need to make sure the seedlings are growing in an environment with a proper temperature. Well, most households have a temperature in the range that plants really need to grow. So don't worry too much about raising the temperature in your house, unless you're growing in a basement and the air temperature is below 60 degrees on a regular basis, then you might need supplemental heat. But normal inside growing air temperature is fine. If you're using an incandescent bulb, it will generate quite a bit of heat. So if it's resting just a few inches away from the seedlings, that actually might be too warm an environment. And you might actually fry those little tender plants with an incandescent bulb. So if that's the type you're using, I would encourage you to raise it up a little bit. Go ahead and put your hand at the level where the seedlings would be growing. If your hand gets hot underneath that incandescent bulb, then the seedlings are probably going to get hot as well. That's one reason why I prefer the fluorescent lights, because they don't generate as much heat, so it's much easier to maintain the proper temperature for the growth of the seedlings. Once you've found a location with a comfortable temperature and the capability of controlling the light distance above those growing seedlings, then you're ready to begin. You're ready to start seeds, and after they germinate and grow, you'll be growing seedlings. In the next video, I'll be discussing the importance of water during that growth process. And air enters the picture again when it comes to keeping the plants healthy. And nutrients then begin to become an important factor. And throughout, the light and the warmth continue to be important. There you have it. How I Grow Seedlings, Part 1. If you have any comments or questions, please let me know below. If you haven't subscribed to the Gardener Scott channel, you can do so now. If you like the video, you can give me a thumbs up and share it. I'm Gardener Scott. Enjoy gardening.